I'm Tatiana Bazzichelli. I am the curator for the Resource for Transmedial program at Transmediale, and I have a background on networking practices and hacker culture and artivism, and also I just finished my PhD on information and media studies, writing about network disruption. That was the title of my dissertation, rethinking opposition in the context of art, business and social media. Yeah, maybe I could describe a bit what the Resource for Transmedial Culture is. This is a new initiative of Transmediale Festival that starts this year. This edition of the festival, Incompatible, and this was initially conceived by Christopher Gansing as an idea of somehow change the format of the festival itself, and trying also to create something that was able to involve more local and translocal community all over the year. And the idea of the resource is somehow to address a meta reflection on artistic and hacker practices. That is also called resource, in the sense for me, I see resource like a restart, so like resource, restart of reflection and think and thoughts about what activism and art means today, especially connected to participatory processes. And trying to create a collaborative peer review process between researchers, artists, hackers, also cultural producers. And at the end of that experience, we created also a newspaper that is today distributed for free as the thematic Transmediale publication. That is also somehow playing with the Murdoch newspaper, The World of the News, but we call it The News of the World. And the idea was to try to address also the topic of peer reviews into a more distributed process, and also trying to somehow rethink what peer review mean in an academic context, but also in an artistic one. So peer review is also the idea of many people working together in the creation of a project that could be either this newspaper or other situations. And so that is also why the resource is sought as a process that started in November, but is passing through the festival and is going on during the year, then going back to Transmediale again. So the idea is that we want to address all the time different thematics that then will have a decisive touchdown at each festival. So this time, of course, in this experience with the researcher at the UDECA, we addressed the topic Incompatible, and then we went into the festival speaking about that yesterday, for example, during the research practice thematic stream. But at the same time, also in the resource at this festival, there are many other things. At the end, we invited around 110 artists only in the resource, and is divided in five specific sub-teams. One is a resource method, that is the one also this reflection on artistic practices and research methodology was part of, but also we have resource network, resource activism, resource markets and resource sex. And all of these thematic streams are somehow sought as a meta-reflection on these specific practices. So, for example, on resource networks, the idea is to reflect on the methodology of networking and participation, especially now after Web 2.0. I really think it's necessary also to recreate, reboot and restart, and to think what networking actually means today after has been deeply commercialized as a practice. And if you remember, I mean, 10 years ago, people that were more involved in net culture were actually a niche of people. And I mean, Transmediale Festival has been part of that, but I would say networking as a concept was not so spread in the society as is today, where all the people are basically using Facebook and social media and so on. So basically, it's important to rethink the concept as well, because we can't ignore that the meaning of it completely changed. So the idea also of the events that are happening here is to try to imagine, for example, different social networks or different form of participation. One project is R15N, that is this experimental telephonic network that is developed by the Telecomunista Network, and is an installation that is going on all the time of the festival, and is also visible in three different postations here in the house. Also, maybe you can hear the ring of the phone. I don't know if the technology is powerful enough, but this is also R15N. Because then you are connected with the two people that are connected with other two people, so you generate a tree. At the end, you create really a network, but of random people that are speaking by phone. So that is also maybe a way to rethink what social networking means. Then, speaking about social activism and resource activism, the idea was also to reflect on practices of artists and hackers that imply collaboration and imply form of participation. Right now is going on the workshop Activism Beyond Interface from Alessandra Renzi and Roberta Bujani, and they are creating like a wooden platform that they call the Sandbox Project, where the people are actually going inside and also exchanging information. So it's still part of the networking culture, but it's still reflecting on what networking is and trying to evolve different new methodologies that are not necessarily online methodologies. And the resource markets is investigating the crisis of the economy as well, and also in which way you can imagine the economy as a more sustainable process and system. So tomorrow there will be a long panel about that is called Crash Economy, Debugging and Rebooting, with Steve Lambert and Jaromil, Shintaro Miyazaki, and Technology of the People. And at the same time, Saturday, there will be an entire stream dedicated to sex. So that is also important for me as a form of reflection on pornography, on sexuality that comes from within, but also critically. And at the same time, we are also reflecting on curating artistic festival and curating artistic practices. That is also why, for example, we invited Coded Culture to create a panel about methodology of curating that will happen today soon. So, I mean, as you can see, the things are really diverse, but they are connected. And the idea is really to try to create meta-reflection on practices that are really practical, no? I mean, not only theory, not only abstraction, as, for example, was commented today during the events Videomakers United. There was an intervention say that they wanted to see more politics at Transmediale. I hope that we are actually managing to do that, because our idea was really to try to address practical situation and also people that are really working in building up things, not only situation, but also really possibility of networking. In / compatible, there is both the incompatible and the compatible. So I would say these are really things that are living together. So, for example, if we speak about sex working, as we will do tomorrow, I just don't want to say that I am against the sex business as such. Maybe we should question question people that are doing something without being conscious, but when you are conscious and you want also to somehow be part of an industry, I don't think there is nothing bad, but still you can question this industry. For me it was important really to invite people that were trying to address questions. So, and the idea of incompatible with the slash in between really demonstrates that the interest, at least for us, was not only to address an holistic concept, but also different concepts that intertwine together, a kind of dialectic process or a coexistence of oppositions. So all the people that I wanted to invite are also people that are basically questioning what they do. So I hope basically all these events will help to address more questions, not to give so much answer, and also to raise some paradoxes or like juxtaposition of concepts and incompatibilities, but always with the slash, because I think it's important to see the matter from different angles. But I would say that my position is that there is not really a strict difference and strict separation between these practices, and especially if you also think about our history, I mean, thinking about fluxus, for example, or even more narrow practices like the mail art and like the postal art, even if they were playing with the concept of art, they were saying that they were not artists. At the same time, they were artists, I mean. So I think for me, since so long, this separation between art and non-art is dead. I would say if you are a hacker, you are also an artist. I mean, what you are also coding is also an art piece. I mean, remember Ars Electronica some years ago gave a prize to Linux as an operative system. So I would say this is kind of old discourse, and in this kind of constellation of practices that I'm trying to bring together with the resource, I hope also to give an answer to that, that is practical, in the sense we are creating art through people that are also engaging with the materiality of the things, like hackers, for example. But for me, hackers are artists. So I would say this definition maybe belongs only to more the, would say, the contemporary art world that still doesn't recognize art, something like hacking. But so depends in which world you want to be. I've never been really interested in organized thing in galleries where then you have to sell your products, or to be in the big art fairs. Maybe it's nice to be there if you're trying to transform what an art fair is, but not because you really want to be part of a specific market. At least I've never been part of my interest, also because it's really difficult to sell these kind of things, and is really not the point. Actually, maybe you are playing with the concept of selling, maybe you are hacking business, you are also disrupting business, but that is art too, and I think art history already demonstrates what art is. So still this division for me is kind of archaeological and should not really be considered anymore. That is also why I think years ago the title of the festival changed from Media Art Festival to Art and Digital Culture, because the idea was really to demonstrate that Transmediale is dealing with art, and art that is made through computer, but not only through computer. I mean, we have really a lot of projects here during this festival that are not really working with any computer. Goodipal, for example, that is there selling your things. I mean, he's not, he doesn't have any digital supplies with him. And that is art too. And after the festival, the resource will go on, and this event will be more like an open platform, really to discuss about topics that then will be brought back into the next Transmediale. And in between, there will be events at Kunst am Kreuzberg Bethania at the end of August, that will be also 3 days of panels discussion, and also a small exhibition in one room of the cultural institution.